I tried Mocha, a fine-tuned model, trained for character replacement by the Orange team. The character replacement results in the given examples looks impressive. The motion and expressions are being followed quite accurately. To get started, all we need is the source video, and then the first frame from that video, which will be used as a mask. The mask setup can be handled within the workflow. The third input is the reference image, and there are actually two reference images, a full body image and a face image. The face image is likely to be used for better facial detail and expression matching. So, with these three inputs, we can achieve the final result. Here are a few more examples below. And I notice a slight change in the character's face in this demo video. It has been years since I saw the movie, but I'm sure this is different from Ron Weasley. The shadows and lighting from the original video are replicated and looks good. It seems the model released is not completed, but still, the model size is not practical for most of the desktop users. So I will be using the smaller FP8 model. The demo videos we saw was most likely generated using the larger model. So there will be a noticeable loss in quality when using the smaller model. This is the workflow I was using and tried to change the character in the video. The workflow is simple. I just had to download these two files, but I will add links to all the files after recording this video. Let's look at some of the results I was able to get before getting into the workflow. The model 12.1 FP8 Mocha for character swap works quite well. The motion is replicated accurately, though the facial expressions seem to be missing in this case. A possible reason could be that I'm using a 3D character with a real human character. By no means this is a perfect model, at least not the FP8 version. The fingers sometimes appear fused, and during quick motions, the face doesn't stay consistent. However, the model is simple to use and removes a few steps from the workflow, while still producing decent results. And that's what makes this model interesting. My video may look low quality because I tried with 30 different subjects to find the best settings. With the same resolution, the block swap technique should make the model work on NVIDIA's 12GB card. If the system has 32GB of RAM for block swap, and then you need to upscale the result to make it look better. For some reason, the model failed to generate the woman putting out her tongue. With the help of QuinEdit model, I generated a different reference image where her tongue was already out. The result does not match exactly with the original video, but somehow it worked. Even with block swap, you will not be able to process long videos. You have to divide the frames and then process. I did multiple batches of 80 frames, and you can see the changes in the result of every batch. To improve this, I uploaded the result generated in the first batch here, and then took the last frame from the video. I will be using this last frame as a reference image in the process of the second batch. I have also taken the image of the face from the result, which is the first frame. I can use this face image directly in the workflow. Or you can have a close-up shot of the image using QuinEdit model. I did not notice much difference in result while testing, though. Upload both the image and process the workflow on the second batch. It took 270 seconds, which is due to the face image. The face image is optional, and without it, the time is around 200 seconds. The reference image from the previous batch worked, and the difference is not much noticeable. I did manage to miss a frame between both the batches. It's better to have an extra frame which can be removed later if it creates a problem. Let's look at the workflow. I've added the links to the files required to run this workflow. In this section of the workflow, you need to upload the video and the reference image. Upload the video to this node and set the FPS, which will be similar to the result video. I prefer 16 FPS. Next is the length of the video, that is, the number of frames to be processed. And then the resolution to resize the uploaded video. The resolution you type now will be the same for generating the result. Below, you need to upload the reference image, and this node removes the background of the character in the reference image. Keeping the background sometimes produces bad result. Next is the face image, which is optional. You can add the background remover here, but I did not feel the difference, so I did not use it. I made a video on this point editor you can watch. So, as shown in the demo video, a mask is required in the process, and the same is generated here. In this section, the video is processed. These red nodes will process the video with the reference image. And above are the nodes which require the model and other files. These yellow nodes require files to run, and the links to download those files are given here. This Torch compile gives error when used with Sage Attention. You can use SDPA instead of Sage Attention with Torch compile. Block swap for low VRAM cards. I have set the value to 40. You can decrease this until you get an out-of-memory error. Keep it as low as you can to make the workflow work with a 12 GB card. The settings in case sampler is the default, but I have changed the schedule because I felt this worked better. And you get a comparison result here. That's all in the workflow. The way you should use this workflow is first you must disable this section and run the workflow. After uploading a video, first you should see something like this. Only the head is selected. And now the t-shirt. Press shift and left click to add a green circle and right click to add a red circle. Now the body has been selected. Once you see the mask is generated properly, activate the remaining nodes and run the workflow. And the process starts. This is the resolution I typed after uploading the video. I showed a simple way to extract the last frame from a video. I will be giving this as well. This should help with long videos. Next is this Outpaint workflow, which I was using a lot. The files needed for this workflow are given. I am using the Flux One reward model, which generates a decent Outpaint. So, the use case is like, I want to work with a video which is similar to a normal mobile screens. I forgot to change the resolution. I will do that quickly. This video info node contains information about the video I uploaded, and I will use the same resolution and try again. Now you can see that the subject is in vertical resolution. And the background remover made the reference image fit the same size for the best result, which also made the character stretch a bit. In such a case, I have used this workflow. The video explains the model's capabilities, which you can watch from the given link. So, I will upload the image and disable the case sampler. And this is the resolution, and now I will quickly add some pixels on the top and at the bottom. Run the workflow. Now I have a long image, which you may need to crop as well. There is some empty space below. I should have added 30 more pixels at the bottom, but you got the point. This is the Quinn Edit model workflow with the prompts, and this is the prompt I used with few changes for man's image, which gave me a close-up shot. The video link is given here, which explains the model and workflow. In case you are not using the second image, which sets the value here. The same value is used above, so make sure to keep it active accordingly. Or else it may give you an error when kept active without any image. So that is it in the video. I hope you have an excellent day.